Stay away from her.
What's up, Monarchs?
JT and Clayton here with your weekly bulletin.
Drama Club presents the Brothers Grimm Speckaloth.
I got it. We'll just keep rolling. Okay. Drama Club presents the Brothers Grimm Spectaculathon. Saturday, April 13th at 6:30 p.m. Saturday, April 13th at 2 p.m. Sunday, April 14th at 3:30 p.m. See an actor or Miss Orr for tickets. Adults are $7 and students are $5.
Volunteers needed.
You know what? I don't know if you can handle. Yeah, I got this one too. We'll just get the next one.
Okay.
Volunteers are needed. FoodLink has an opportunity for community service hours on April 20th, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. in Exeter. See Mrs. Trevino for more information.
Are you going to hit this one too?
I mean, if you're not taking it, I'll do it. Attention, okay. Senior girls, save the date for April 24th. You are invited to our annual mother-daughter tea. Sign up in the counseling office. Don't miss this long-standing tradition. Last day to RSVP is April 16th.
Prom dress giveaway will be Saturday, April...
I got it. Prom dress giveaway will be Saturday, April 13th at the Wyndham Hotel in Visalia. Sign up at the counseling office and let us know if you need transportation to and from. Oh. Community service hours. Lincoln PTO is putting on a school carnival on Friday, May 3rd from 4 to 8 p.m. on the Lincoln campus and will need lots of help with carnival games and the snack booth. It is a great opportunity to get hours done. Contact Katie Ringgill at 559-302-0207 if you're interested in volunteering. Don't forget, Key Club meets every Thursday in Mrs. Rios' classroom, room 41. Pizza's $1. We have, you know what?
No, stay away. Let me say this part.
All right, man.
Don't forget, Key Club meets every Thursday in Mrs. Rios' classroom, room 41. Pizza's $1. We have some great opportunity service. Oh, my bad, you go again.
We have some great community service days coming up. See you there. Campus life is in room 15 every Monday during lunch, and lunch is provided. Come out to get some pizza and some great fellowship.
Attention all seniors, Senior Assassin will begin this year. Roll the clip. What's up, Exeter Union High School? We're excited to announce the very first Exeter Senior Assassin. Here are the rules.
Having a floaty, goggles, or a pool noodle makes you immune.
You cannot eliminate your enemies on school events, school grounds, the student parking lot, and even sporting events.
These water wars are not affiliated with Exeter High School.
Participate in these games outside of school. Go Monarchs!
And your location has to be on at all times.
Houses are allowed, but no breaking and entering. You gotta ask for permission. May I come in?
Yeah.
Work and places of worship are off limits, but their parking lots are fair game.
No Nerf guns or splat guns allowed. Water guns only.
You have to provide your own water gun and you cannot shoot anybody in the face.
Be safe. Have fun.
Senior Assassin starts next Wednesday, April 17th. Be ready.
We
gotta cut this clip, bro.
Let's head over to Logan and Ryder for sports. Dude, you're such a disappointment, dude.
Hello, Monarchs.
I'm Logan.
And I'm Ryder, here with your sports updates brought to you by Kirkman's VIP Pizza.
Last Thursday, our boys' golf team participated in the Kings League tournament at Kirkman. Alexis Arias shot a 43 in 9 holes, being the top scorer for the Monarchs.
Last Friday at Clovis, Paisley Pace got 13th out of 30 girls. She made all cuts today and had a great meet.
On Saturday, Dallas White placed 7th out of 13, qualifying for Valley. Way to go.
Woo! On Tuesday, our boys' tennis team took on CVC for their senior night. Kylie had the chance to talk to the team. Let's see what they had to say.
Hey Monarchs, today we're at boys' tennis, their senior night. Let's go see what they have to say. Who am I here with?
Jerry.
So Jerry, how do you feel knowing that this is your last home match?
You know, it's pretty sad, but you know, it's really cool since, you know, this is my first year coming out, and it's pretty sad that this is already one of the last few games already.
Okay, and how do you feel going into it? Like, what's your pregame? Like, how do you feel?
I feel pretty good, you know. Pregame, you know, I just think, you know, what's one point at a time, and that's how I determine each match.
Okay, thank you. Who am I here with?
Eli.
So, are you gonna miss the seniors?
I mean, not entirely. No, yeah, I will.
They bring a lot of fun to this sport.
What's your pregame? How do you warm up?
I hit the ball.
More in depth, please.
I hit the ball into the court as hard as I can and hope that I don't screw up.
Okay, thank you, Eli.
Thank you.
Who am I here with?
Coach Hendricks.
So how do you feel about these group of seniors and this being their last home game?
It's always a bittersweet moment. There's some of them that have been here for 4 years, others of them 4 months. But they've been a really hardworking group, a lot of fun to just hang out with and just play. They work hard, they have fun, and they just have a lot of energy. And so it's going to be sad to see them go.
And what are your feelings going into these matches?
I feel like every game we go into, we have a chance to win. We have guys that have really stepped up this year, played a lot of really close games against really good teams. And our newbies have grown a lot, and our veterans are playing hard. So I think we got a chance to win today. It's going to be really hard against a tough CVC team. And then I'm looking forward to these tough games leading us up into playoffs in a couple weeks.
Thank you. That's it for this week's Sports On Site. See you guys next time.
Thanks, guys. At home, our baseball team played against the Reedley Pirates. Cade McElmy hit a single that scored 2 runs, and Tyler Tremble hit a walk-off single in the bottom of the seventh, defeating the Pirates 8-7. Way to go.
Now for this week's giveaway, brought to you by Kirkman's VIP Pizza, where you can get 2 slices of pizza and a large drink for $6.50. Box of Destiny, please. Oh. And our winners are Janie Mendez.
You are my sunshine.
And Isabella Aguilar.
My there you go.
Only sunshine.
Don't forget to pick up your certificate for a free lunch from Kirkman's VIP Pizza in Miss Reed's office.
Well, that wraps up this week's sports. We'll see you next week.
Whoa.
Hold it. Hold it.
Bro, practice makes perfect, bro.
Oh, God.
It could take forever.
We have to do 5?
We have to do 5 of these.
That's crazy.
I'm gonna be here all day, bro.
We're gonna run him through. I'm gonna go get the chip, bro. I need a
what's the game?
I need a chip. Turkish Quandale Dingle. Hey, I need a group of 4.
Coach, you know where the stopwatch is
at? Yes.
Come on over here.
It's our time, man.
I got a group of 4 right here.
Yeah, and then bring them over here.
I got a group of 4.
What's up, Lamb?
It's a squad. I'm about to run these. I run these. Simple as that.
Full speed. 120.
So I don't need to walk around? Oh, sorry. I don't know. I don't understand this. This is so confusing. It's the bandana. It's more aerodynamic.
I'm Colton Mayo.
I'm Andrew Taylor.
And this is Mike Duck. Peace.
Hi, this is Chloe. We're out here doing What's Next, and I'm with
Abel Cruz.
So Abel, what are you planning on doing for college?
Majoring in nursing and being in the jazz band.
Tell me more about the jazz band.
I was going to be with Tackett, and I've worked with him a couple times through honor bands. He's going to be the jazz director. We usually go to Reno once every other year, and hoping to attend one of them.
What do you think sparked this passion for you?
Definitely my directors from different areas. My elementary school director especially.
What college are you planning on attending?
CUS.
So how has high school been for you, and what are you most excited for moving on?
It was pretty good. Good years. I'll say just to this new chapter in my life, see how it goes.
What are you most going to miss about Exeter Union?
The people, for sure. The people, the teachers, my friends. Yeah.
Thank you. That's it for What's Next this week. See you guys next time.
we take our shoes off?
Yeah.
It's recording.
Welcome to the second episode of Rostering. Today we're going to be making a basketball team, one made of men and one made of women. Now, come hither. I'll be choosing women.
I'll be choosing men.
You go.
Not at all. I'm gonna start with a mascot pick. It's pretty spunky. It's pretty likable. I'm gonna go Jack Black.
Put in a little Jack Black riff. I'll hit Andrew right back with a mascot pick. The Monsters, Inc. The one that goes, Mike Wazowski. You know that one?
I know that one.
I don't know her name.
The Slug.
Slug.
We need a point guard. Point guards are usually small. Not that this has anything to do with my pick. Give me Peter Dinklage.
You know, I'm blanking on every woman right now. I'm going with a center. This lady can really get up there. Give me Amelia Earhart. Control the skies, baby, control the skies.
I need someone who can control the paint. They need to be strong. Handsome. Give me big DP. Darren Pace.
Great pick. All right, so this might be a little known fact to some of you, but my next pick is in fact a girl. So there will be no debate about this. My power forward is Godzilla. Godzilla is a woman.
I'm really blanking right now, but I've seen a lot about the TikTok Riz Party.
Okay.
Shooting guard, give me Turkish Quandale Dingle.
You know what? You saying TikTok has really inspired me. Give me Charlie D'Amelio as my shooting guard.
Throwback.
Hit the, what'd she do?
This one's gonna be a little more underground. But I think he's a decent leader, as long as he doesn't leave. Give me John Stern as our coach and leader.
Wow, that is a crazy toss-up. Give me, for my small forward, give me Heidi Carmen, someone I can depend on. She's got the length.
All-state baton twirler back in the day.
She could probably do it with the basketball too. So now to judge and see who won this bout of drafting, we have the host of Question Corner himself, Ryder One.
Correct.
Correct.
Wow.
Okay,
it really works.
So what drafts you got? What drafts you got? Ooh, these are some good picks. I'm gonna have to go with Drew. I'm sorry.
This concludes Rostering Episode 2. It was stolen from me again. I had Godzilla on my team.
We'll see you next time. Bye.
Well, that wraps up this week's season. As always,
stay what? Stay literate, Monarchs.
Right.